Now, I thank God for all three. I'm thankful that he rules when it comes to my sin. I thank God that he can forgive my sin, because some other people like to rule over that part of my life. Yeah. In fact, they think they do sometimes, because they're always trying to remind you of the stuff you used to do. Yeah, they're trying to always throw that stuff in your face, what you used to do. The devil wants you to live in guilt. He wants you to doubt your salvation, but don't you let his schemes work on you. Yeah. You tell him, yes, I did it. Yes, I'm guilty of it, but guess what? God forgave me. Yeah. And when the enemy tries to give you a guilt trip, you let him know that there is now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Thank God he's king of my sin. Not only is he king over my sin, but I thank God he also ruled over my sorrow. I'm glad that when things discourage me and bring doubt and despair, I can go to God in prayer. Songwriter said, in the seasons of distress and grief, my soul has often found sweet relief. And it's not just about the praying that brings me relief, it's about the fact that I'm praying to an almighty sovereign God, who's sovereign over my sorrows, God over my grief, master over my mistakes, misery, and mishap. He has all power in his hand. He specializes. Anybody in here have any rivers you can't swim? Any mountains you can't climb? I got a God, he specializes in things that seem impossible, and he can do. But no other power can do. So I thank God he rules over my sorrow. Not only does he rule over my sorrow, he rules over my sin, but he also rules over my strength. And let me put it where you can get it. He rules over the things that make me sweat. And you fret a little bit, you get some panic, you get a little nervous. We're all human, and we get concerned, and we get uptight, and you ought to care about some things, but Jesus is king of your sweat. Those things that make you worry, he's got them under his feet. He's king of those things that cause you fear and worry. He's more concerned about the things that concern you. He said, cast your cares upon me. Because I care. For you. So he's king. Yeah. And so what are you concerned about? Nah. What's on your heart? What's causing you to sweat? What sorrow and grief is trying to grip your life? I've got good news. Jesus is king.
Yeah.
He's king over every care. Yeah. He's king over every storm. Yeah. He's king over every problem, every situation, every crisis, every difficulty, every disappointment, any dilemma you got. The soldiers said, watch this, hail King of the Jews. they were almost right, because he's not just King of the Jews, but he's King of Kings.
Yeah.
And he's what? Lord of Lords. Yeah. They didn't know it then, but every knee shall bow, and every tongue is going to confess. And although he was a king of matchless worth, he wore a crown of thorns, that I might wear a crown of glory. He laid down his heavenly splendor to bring me love's sweet story. So poverty, he walked life's way. In the garden, he vowed to pray. He wore a crown of thorns, that I might wear a crown of glory. And Pilate looks at it. Exactly. And said, I find. In verse 4, he says the first time, I find no fault in you. And the Bible says, then came Jesus.
Yeah.
You ought to be able to see him now.
Yeah.
He's a bloody mess.
Yeah.
There's blood everywhere. He's barely recognizable. He's wearing the crown of thorns. And the purple robe. He didn't look like much. He didn't look like a savior then.
And Pilate said, behold me. Take a look at it.
Yeah.
And verse 6 again, he says, I find no fault. He was a sinner, but he spoke the truth. I've never found any fault in myself. I mean, he's water when I'm thirsty. He's my shelter in the midst of a storm. He's the joy of my salvation. I found no fault. In a matter of fact, and he's got all the love I need. And they say, away with him. Crucified. And they led him away to be crucified. There were some women crying in the way. He said, baby, don't weep for me.
All right,
now. You need to weep for you and your children.
Yeah. All right, all right.
But if you do these things in the green tree, what's going to happen in the dry? And they led him up a hill called Calvary. Y'all know the story, don't you? There they nailed him to a cross, still with this crown on his head. Now he has nails in his hands. And nailed to the cross. But I heard him say, if I be fulfilled, I'll draw all men to me. And so they lifted him up between heaven and earth. He said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They hung him high and they stretched him out. Put his head in the locks of his shoulders and he died. Placed him in a bar or two, but you know that's not how the story ends.
Yeah.
3 days later, come on, he got up with all power in his hand. Somebody needs to come to the Lord this morning.
Yeah. Right.
Today is the day of salvation.
Yeah.
Harden not your heart.
Yeah.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not but have everlasting life. Today is the day of salvation. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. Now is the time. Today is the day. The Lord is calling. Whosoever will, let him come. Jesus said, behold, I stand at the door. And I know. He's bled, he's suffered, he's died. Got up, and guess what? He's coming back again. Will you be ready?